without wasting more time, let us start our today's session. In our previous session, we have completed exercise number 1.2. My dear students, I hope you all understood that exercise. So now in today's session, we are going to learn multiplication of integers. Okay, multiplication of integers. In that, first we learn positive integers and negative integers. That means multiplication of positive integer with negative integer. Okay, so it's very simple. Look at this here. When we multiply two integers, of them one is positive and one is negative. Okay, when we multiply two integers, of them one is positive and one is negative, then the product is negative. Okay, so in multiplication, positive into negative is negative. Now here a into negative b, here the integer a is positive and b is negative, the product is negative. Also if a is negative and b is positive, then also product is negative. So this means what? Well, we multiply two integers, if one of them is negative, then answer is negative. So remember the students, in multiplication, positive into negative is negative. Okay, so look at here there are some examples. Now tell me, what will be 3 into negative 4 is 3 into negative 4. Now 3 into 4 is 12, but here there is a negative sign, and in multiplication, positive into negative is negative, so answer is negative. So therefore 3 into negative 4 is negative 12, right? Now negative 5 into 4, here there is a sign of multiplication, one integer is positive, one integer is negative. In multiplication, positive into negative is negative, so negative 5 into 4 is negative 20. Now tell me, 2 into negative 3, very nice, 2 into negative 3 is negative 6. Now negative 6 into 7, right, negative 42. That means positive into negative is negative in multiplication. Okay students, now multiplication of two negative integers, when both the integers are negative, so let us look what will happen. Here we have to multiply two negative integers, okay, that is negative a into negative b. So both the integers are negative, then their product will be positive. Whenever two integers are negative, then their product will be positive. That means in multiplication, negative into negative is positive, negative into negative is positive. Okay, so look at here negative 5 into negative 6, here there are two integers 5 and 6, and both the integers are negative. Look at here carefully, negative 5 into negative 6, so product of these two integers, it will be positive 30. Negative into negative is positive. Okay, now look at here, negative 4 into negative 3, in this case also 4 and 3, both are negative, so their product is positive. Very nice, so 4 into 3 is 12. Again negative 10 into negative 2, so it will be 20, right? So remember students, when both the integers are negative, their product is positive. Okay, now observe this following table. Okay, here first term is negative 3 into 4. Now you all know that negative 3 into 4, one is positive and one is negative, so product is negative. Negative 3 into 4 is equal to negative 12, right? Now negative 3 into 3, okay, negative 3 into 3, it is negative 9. Okay, so it comes from here, right? Negative 12, negative 12, minus negative 3. So it will become from negative 12 minus negative 3. So what will be the answer of this? Negative 12 minus negative 3 is negative 12. In multiplication, negative into negative is positive. So negative 12 plus 3, which is negative 9. So negative 3 into 3 is negative 9. It will come from this, from previous multiplication. Negative 12 minus negative 3. That means we subtract negative 3 from this negative 12. Now here, look at here. Negative 3 into 2. Negative 3 into 2. So negative 3 into 2 is negative 6. Now it comes from previous product. That means negative 9 minus negative 3. If we subtract negative 3 from this, we get negative 3 into 2, right? So negative 9 minus negative 3. So this minus and minus plus, that means negative 6. So answer is negative 6. Okay. Now negative 3 into 1, look at here. Negative 3 into 1, which is negative 3, it comes from that negative 6. If we subtract negative 3 from negative 6, if we subtract negative 3 from negative 6, then we get the answer negative 3 here. Okay. Now negative 3 into 0. Negative 3 into 0 is 0. It comes from previous product. Negative 3 minus negative 3. That means negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Okay. I recall here negative 3 into 4, which is negative 12. Now negative 3 into 3 is negative 9. It comes from negative 12. How it will come from negative 12? We subtract negative 3 from this negative 12. Negative 12 minus negative 3, which will give us negative 9. Okay. Negative 3 into 2 is negative 6. It comes from that negative 9. Negative 9 minus negative 3. Negative 3 into 1 is negative 3. It comes from this negative 6 minus negative 3, which is negative 3. Negative 3 into 0 is equal to 0. It comes from negative 3 minus negative 3. So answer is okay. So after that, 4, 3, 2, 1. Look at here. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay? 0. After 0, we get negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and so on. That means next step is negative 3 into negative 1. Okay, look at here. Negative 3 into negative 1. So now negative 3 into negative 1. Okay? How will it come from? From this. If we subtract 0 from, if we subtract negative 3 from this 0, then we get the answer of negative 3 into negative 1. We have to find negative 3 into negative 1. It will come from this. We subtract 0, negative 3 from this 0. That means here 0 minus negative 3. Now negative, negative, positive. That is 3. That means negative 3 into negative 1 is equal to what? 3. Right? Now negative 3 into negative 2, it will come from this 3, okay, previous product. That means 3 minus negative 3. If we subtract negative 3 from this 3, 3 minus negative 3, that is 6, right? Now negative 3 into negative 3, negative 3 into negative 3, answer from this 6, 6 minus negative 3, 6 minus negative 3, so it will be 9. So from this pattern of negative 3, we observe that, okay, what will be our observation here? We observe that negative 3 into negative 1, negative 3 into negative 1, which is 3, negative 3 into negative 2, it is 6, negative 3 into negative 3, it will be 9. That means we observe that product of two negative integers is positive. Remember the students, product of two negative integers is positive. Okay, so up to this, we have learned here, in multiplication, if one integer is positive and one is negative, then our product is negative. That means in multiplication, positive into negative is negative. And if both the integers are negative, then their product is positive. So product of two negative integers is always positive. Product of two negative integers is always positive. Okay, students, do you understand this? Okay. So students, up to this, we have learned product of two negative integers is positive. Now let us look what will happen product of more than two negative integers, or product of three negative integers, product of four negative integers, and so on. Okay, so let us start here. Look at the board carefully. Product of three or more negative integers. Okay, so we check the product of more than three or more than two negative integers. Okay, look at your first example. Your first example is negative 2 into negative 3. Negative 2 into negative 3. That means two negative integers. The product of two negative integers is positive. That means we get negative into negative is positive. So our answer is 6. Here there are two negative integers, right? Here there are two negative integers. Okay. Now look at the second example here. Negative 1 into negative 4 into negative 3. Okay, now there are three negative integers, 1, 2 and 3. Here there are three negative integers. Okay, so now look at the product here. First we multiply first two numbers. That means negative 1 into negative 1, 4. Here product of two negative integers is positive. That means negative into negative is positive. So negative 1 into negative 4 is equal to 4. Into negative 3. Then we multiply with this. 4 into negative 3. Now positive into negative is negative. So our answer is negative 3. Negative 5. Okay. So our answer is negative. Okay. What this example says that if there are 3 negative integers, then product is negative. Right. Okay. Now look at the third example. Here also three negative integers. First, second and third. Okay, we have to multiply three negative integers. Now first we multiply two negative integers. Negative into negative is positive. So negative 5 into negative 6, which is 30, positive. And if we multiply this 30 with negative 10, now positive into negative is negative. So our answer is here negative 30. Here there are also 1, 2 and 3. 3 negative integers. That means product of 3 negative integers is negative. Okay. Now consider 4 negative integers. Okay. Fourth example. Negative 1 into negative 2 into negative 3 into negative 4. Now there are 4 negative integers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we have to find the product of 4 negative integers. So let us look what will happen here. First we multiply negative 1 into negative 2. Okay. Pair of this integer. Negative 1 into negative 2 it is 2. Right. And negative 3 into negative 4 is positive 12. Since negative into negative is positive. That means here we get product of first two integer, it will be 2, and product of this negative 3 into negative 4 is 12. So 2 into 12 is 24. So here we get the positive product. Okay. That means there are 4 positive integers, 4 negative integers, and we get the product of 4 negative integer is positive. Product of 4 negative integer is positive here. Okay. Now look at the fifth example. Now in fifth example there are 5 negative integers. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are 5 negative integers. So we have to find the product of 5 negative integers.
get about here? Negative 1 into negative 2. Answer is 2. Negative 3 into negative 4. Negative into negative? Positive. That means 12. And into that negative 5. Now, 2 12s are 24. And 24 5s are 120. But there is negative sign, so answer is negative. Here we use 5 negative integers. Okay? So it will show that product of 5 negative integer is negative. Product of 5 negative integer is negative. Okay? Now look at the last example, which is 6th one here. Now there are 6 positive negative integers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. There are 6 negative integers. So now let us look. What will happen? Product of these 6 negative integers. So here we make pair of 2. Okay. So negative 1 into negative 2 is 2. Negative 3 into negative 4, 12. Negative 5 into negative 6, 30. Okay. Or negative into negative, positive. Here also negative into negative, positive. Here also negative into negative, positive. So all numbers are positive. So product of this positive number, it will be 720. 2 12s are 24 and 24 into 30. Answer it will be 720. Here we use 6 positive integers. Right? So it shows that product of 6 negative integers is positive. Okay? So now students, look here. In first example, there are 2 negative integers. In first examples, there are 2 negative integers. 2 negative integers and product is positive, right? Product is positive. In third example, there are 3 negative integers. There are 3 negative integers and the product is negative. In fourth example, there are 4 negative integers. 4 negative integers and the product is positive, right? In fifth example here, there are 5 negative integers. 5 negative integers here and the product is negative. In sixth example, here there are 6 negative integers. 6 negative integers and the product is positive. Now my dear students, what is your observation? Observe all 6 examples and tell me what will be your observation from this. Okay, I will tell you. Okay, now look at here. Here 2, 4, 6. They are even numbers, right? What are the even numbers? The numbers which are divisible by 2 are called as even numbers. And the numbers which are not divisible by 2 are called as odd numbers. Okay. So, now 2, 4 and 6. These are even numbers. Okay. And 3 and 5. They are odd numbers since they are not divisible by 2. So, 2, 4, 6 are even numbers here and 3 and 5 are odd numbers. Okay. That means when the number of negative integers are even, then we get the product is positive. When number of negative integers is even, 2, 4, 6, then we get the product is positive. And when the number of negative integers is odd, number of negative integers is odd, then we get the product is negative. Okay? So remember students, it is very important. So look at the board here. If the number of negative integers in a product is even, if the number of negative integers in a product is even, then the product is a positive integer. Okay? And if the number of negative integers in a product is odd, then product is negative integers. Okay? So you have to keep it in mind, these two statements, these are very important statements. while doing the multiplication of negative integers. Okay, when number of negative integers are even, then product is positive integer, and when the number of negative integers are odd, then product is negative integers. Okay students, do you understand all this? So in this session we have the multiplication of integers. When one integer is positive and one integer is negative, in multiplication we get positive into negative is negative. Okay, then when both the integers are negative, okay, both the integers are negative, then product is positive. And if we perform the multiplication of negative numbers for more than 3 negative integers, then if number